Welcome back, friends. In the last lecture, we were dealing with some of the concepts related to the scalars and vectors. We have gone through position vectors and distance vector. What is the difference between position vector and distance vector? We have understood, and now we'll see some more important concept. We have solved one example also. We'll see vector multiplication. This is unavoidable part of vector calculus, where you need to have a multiplication between two vectors. Either it can be a dot product, it can be a cross product, it can be a scalar triple product or vector triple product. But more oftenly, we are going to use these two products, scalar product and vector product. See, why the name is scalar product or dot product? If you have a dot product between two vectors, the resulting entity will be a scalar one, and that's why dot product results in the scalar. Remember this particular thing. First of all, before dealing with any of these multiplication, try to understand the basic difference between these. So the dot product will result in scalar, first thing. Okay, vector or cross product, A bar cross B bar, will going to result in vectors. So whatever entity will get, whatever result we will get, it will be in the vector form. Scalar triple product, A dot B bar cross C bar. Now this cross product will result in certain vector, and we already know vector dot vector, the result will be scalar. So scalar triple product will result in scalar, and similarly vector triple product, this cross product B bar cross C bar will result in vector. Vector cross vector is once again a vector, as we know from our basic concepts. So basically there are four types of multiplication: scalar product or dot product. Let's look at this dot product first of all. Now in the dot product, how we represent dot product? A bar dot B bar is equal to mod of A bar into mod of B bar into cos of theta between A bar and B bar. So cos theta AB, you can represent this as cos theta. Now so A bar dot B bar is equal to what we understood? A bar dot B bar is equal to AB cos theta AB. And what is this cos theta? Theta is angle between two vectors AB. Now once we need to calculate the angle between two vectors, we can directly write cos theta AB is equal to A bar dot B bar divided by AB, and we can calculate the angle at any moment of time. So finding the angle between two vector is also made easy by using the definition of dot product. So I will use this definition to calculate the angle between two vector very easily. Now what this going to result in and what are the properties of this dot product, we will see in the forthcoming slides. Now vector or cross product. Now A bar cross B bar, I need to calculate cross product between two vectors A bar and B bar. How I can write? A bar cross B bar is equal to AB sin theta AB. So what is that? Similarly here, a cos theta in the dot product, sin theta in the vector product or cross product. So A bar cross B bar is equal to AB sin theta AB, and the most important thing is this AN cap or AN bar. What is this AN cap or AN bar? This indicates the unit normal vector perpendicular to the plane containing A bar and B bar. What I mean to say, let's say there are two vectors randomly oriented. This, let's say, suppose this is A bar vector and another vector is a B bar vector, and now they are in the plane of bold. Now you can understand this. There are two vectors, I need to cross them. So A bar cross B bar, so I am going to come in this direction, A bar cross B bar. So certain direction I am going to calculate, A bar cross B bar. So the plane containing, let's say this is a board which contains two vectors A bar and B bar. So there are two vectors which can be normal to this plane, one coming towards you, one going away from you inside the board. See, try to understand this AN cap. So two vectors, two unit normal vectors can be treated. One unit normal vector coming outside the plane of paper here towards me or towards you, and going away from us from the back side of the board. So there, these are two unit vectors. So whenever we are calculating cross product, we need not we have to consider this AN cap. This is a unit normal vector in the direction of plane of paper or plane of board anyways. And you usually know we need to calculate this A bar cross B bar by solving certain determinant. You have solved this by IJK. Here I will solve it by AX bar, AY bar, AZ bar. So three vectors I will take. These three are unit vector, as we have gone through in the last lecture. These three are the unit vectors in the direction of X, Y, Z respectively. then I will put coefficients of A, AX, AY, AZ, then I will put coefficients of B, BX, BY, BZ, and I will get the answer. And now whatever answer you are getting, this answer in terms of AX, AY, AZ is nothing but a unit normal vector which is perpendicular to the plane of A bar and B bar. So we'll see this when the time comes, because cross product is required for us when we will enter into the magnetostatic. But for first unit, we will be dealing with mostly with the dot product, A bar dot B bar. So our more focus during this course will be more on dot product and cross product. Scalar triple product is required sometimes, but we'll see as and when time comes, and we'll give stress on vector triple product also as and when time comes. Now let's look at some of the properties of this dot product. Dot product is very easy to understand. It is commutative. Commutative property we have already seen. A plus B equal to B plus A is a commutative nature of anything. So commutative, A plus B, B plus A, that's it. Distributive, yes, dot product is distributive. A dot B plus C is equal to A dot B plus A dot C. And this is important, A dot A is A square. So whenever I am writing A dot A, I can represent this as directly A square. So dot product between two entities, you can calculate simply by applying our logic. Dot product between the same vector. So A bar dot A bar is A into cos theta of AA. What will be the angle between two similar vectors? It will be definitely 0. Cos 0 leads to 1. So A dot A will result in A square. That's it. So by knowing the basic property also we can understand. And the last important property you know is this property in terms of IJK. We'll try to remember this property in terms of AX, AY, AZ. So AX dot AY, AY dot AZ, AZ dot AX is 0. This is very, very important. Star mark this, since we need to understand this basic property when we'll have this vector multiplication. And it is throughout required, the discussion, whenever we are discussing electromagnetic problem, this is required to understand, this is needed to be understood. So AX dot AY, AY dot AZ, AZ dot AX, any dissimilar entities you take, that will result in 0. And whenever we are talking about similar entities, AX dot AX, AY dot AY, AZ dot AZ, capital A bar dot A bar, so this will result in its multiplication. So AX dot AX, what it will result in? Mod of AX bar into mod of AX bar. But we know, whenever we are representing anything with a small a, it indicates it's a unit vector. So unit vector multiplied by unit vector multiplied by unit vector will result in the entity as 1. So this is also an important property, because whenever there is a similar entity, similar unit vector, then only multiplication is possible. Whenever there are dissimilar unit vector, multiplication will result in 0. That's it. These are three important properties that one must understand. Going to the cross product. Now, cross product is difficult to solve when it comes to the analysis of the cross product. But let's understand this vector multiplication, properties of vector multiplication and cross product. Now, cross product is not commutative. A bar cross B bar is not equal to B bar cross A bar. This is an important thing. As it was applicable in dot product, not necessarily it should be applicable in the vector product or cross product. So A bar cross B bar is not equal to B bar cross A bar. It is anti-commutative. What I mean to say, anti-commutative means A bar cross B bar is rather minus B bar cross A bar. Try to understand. Since A bar cross B bar is not B bar cross A bar, it is minus of B bar cross A bar. Why it is so? We'll understand this by looking at this particular diagram. Then it is not at all associative. Once again, the same thing, it is not distributive. Okay, and last property, cross product between similar entity. Earlier we have seen A bar dot A bar is A square, but A bar cross A bar in vector product or cross product will result in 0 entity. Why it results in same entity? See, these are some of the important things that you must know. AX cross AY is equal to AZ bar. This is simply I cross J equal to K. I cross K equal to, this is not AX, this is AX, AX cross AY, AX cross AY is equal to AZ, AX cross AZ is equal to AZ cross AX is equal to AY, and this is the third one. Let's understand this. So whenever I am traveling in the clockwise direction, see AX cross AY. So AX cross AY, I am going in the clockwise direction. You just write AX, AY, AZ in the clockwise direction on the circle. AX cross AY will result in AZ, that is the third entity. AY cross AZ is equal to AX. So it is AY. Actually, this should be AY. So AY cross AZ is equal to AX. And finally, AZ cross AX is equal to AY. Whenever we are going into the cross clockwise direction, try to understand this X cross Y will result in Z, that is the third coordinate. Z cross X result in Y, and X cross Y once again result in Z. So similarly, this kind of nature you will understand, and you need to solve this by simply by solving the matrix equation also, but this is important. And last equation which I want to tell, AX cross AX is 0. This is important. AX cross AX is 0. AX cross AY cross AY is also 0. AZ cross AZ is also 0. So once you understand this particular thing, that how, what is the difference between dot product and cross product, and how it results in multiplication, and what I need to what I supposed to calculate when I do this vector multiplication, all the things will be more and more clear. So right now we will stop here. We will try to solve certain examples in the next coming lecture, and there the concept will be more and more clear. Okay, in the next lecture I will once again revise this vector multiplication concept, and I will go back to here one numerical associated with it. Till then, stay home, stay safe, and keep learning. Thank you very much.